Introduction-wise with this camera, it's like you always want something that can give you a large amount of options in a cinema sense, but be small and mobile, because no one wants to carry a massive camera. And I think that was the first thing we both realized.
It was really useful having the monitor on the back of the camera be so flexible, so you can move it in various different ways. These lenses are good as well because they're small.
Yeah.
So it's perfect for the gimbal.
Like when we're changing lenses, there's things like you'll turn off the camera, open the lens, and then the shutter shield will come down. And it stops you from getting dirt with the sensor.
Which is great. There were a lot of elements we didn't need to add to the camera. It has built-in autofocus, which is amazing. The tracking is great. We were both worried that we would need a focus puller because of the amount of movement that we had going on in the video. It was a lot of pressure on the camera, but it performed and it was great. The in and outs of the focus are smooth. It's not really obvious that it's autofocus, and it worked really well.
It gives you more options in terms of being fluid and being able to move around. I think we were shooting 4K, N-Log, RAW, but then we also had the option of shooting like ProRes RAW or ProRes, and that's kind of greater flexibility.
The exposure was, it was a lot darker inside the fabric than it was outside at some points. So having the range that we can then go into the editing, feeling confident that the information is there is amazing.